Folks, welcome to the broadcast. And yes, they may very well be building Dick Cheney's wheelchair right now in a deep in an underground bunker. It just makes logical sense that the next step of Dick Cheney is he's floating around in the air with his hydrogen drive and life extension and his all-powerful wheelchair overseeing the battlefield of all future. In any case, we're not here for Dick Cheney tonight, and I'm a little under the weather, so we may not go a full 30 minutes, but I do want to revisit the FOIA Freedom of Information document. Freedom of Information documents are of critical importance in our day and age. You know, Obama promised transparency, and they all do. Not to pick on Obama, it will be no different. But they promised transparency, and they become the most secretive administration we've ever seen or known. So it's critical that we have transparency, and that's what Freedom of Information is all about. And when you apply and you sue for documents and that you have to pay for them. They're not free, of course, and you have to wait for them to come in. But as was with the case with Fukushima, there were people filing early on. And these are, you know, some of them were mainstream outlets. But again, it shows that people know that when these incidences happen, the first thing you do is file for freedom of information. And this is old school stuff. I mean, I'm coming in new to the scene. I haven't even had my laptop. About a year or something. So and I haven't been on Facebook very long, haven't been on YouTube very long, so I'm getting broken into all this and getting quite a lesson here. Meanwhile, the number one alternative news outlet, and that would be InfoWars Prison, they didn't file for freedom of information, not to my knowledge. If they did, they certainly haven't spoken much about it, and that's part of my contention is that the alternative media, some of the biggest outlets, pretty much all of them as far as I know, they didn't highlight, showcase, and pray this information around. And when they did speak of it, it was like in hushed tones and in small print and barely even touched upon the subject. So my contention is when you understand the scope and size of the cover-up, when you understand the fatalities involved, and you understand this isn't the first time this has happened, I mean, it really begins to come out and you really get the full scope and size. And it's pretty maddening to some extent to know this has happened and there's absolutely, you know, almost no movement in the direction of justice in this matter. And that's what we got to do is bring it to the attention of everybody we know and get them involved and start spreading the word. So let's go right to the Freedom of Information document I've chosen tonight, which I have a link on the YouTube video that I posted up early today. And I'm going to start, I'm on the wrong page here. I want to go look at some talking points. So if you go to page 15, this is a 413-page document, and that's how I refer to them because, like I say, they didn't make it easy for us to go through them. It was a blizzard effect where they released a whole bunch at once. They weren't in any chronological order. There's heavy redaction, lots of duplicated stuff, so they did their best to obfuscate our research into the matter, but nevertheless, we have investigate and we have some information. So I'm on page 15. Let me back up one more page. And these are talking points, what we're looking at right now. Many of you will be familiar with talking points. They're not spoken of in a term of admiration because we know what talking points are all about, avoiding answering the question. Politicians are honed and polished in the art of talking points. In fact, Hillary Clinton, I will give her credit. I watched her be interviewed by a lady from Pakistan, and she was asking her questions about drones, and during the course of the 10-15 minute answer, it was a long answer, she never even touched upon that question in any way, shape, or form. So she just used talking points and just danced around the issue, and they're very good at that. So talking points, we're through with that. We're tired of that. We want the information, and we want it now. We're American citizens. We pay our taxes. We stay out of trouble, and this is unacceptable. So let's have a look. We're on page 15, and what we want to look at here is talking point number 3. Quote, what should people in Alaska, Hawaii, and the West Coast do to protect themselves from fallout? And they classified in the public answer and the, quote, additional technical non-public information. But we do not get to hear. And the worse it is, the less chance of us hearing it. I'll put it that way. Public answer. The available evidence shows the United States can be expected to avoid any impacts from radioactive materials, so no public action is necessary. We believe there is very low risk to the U.S. considering the long distance from the U.S. and the type of event. The NRC continues to analyze the available information, and existing monitoring equipment can detect any materials before they could present a hazard. Now, additional technical non-public information. NRC is working with the DHS, EPA, and other federal partners to ensure monitoring equipment is properly positioned based on meteorological and other relevant information. So while in one answer they say, nothing to worry about, it's no big deal, it's long distance, and the other answer amongst themselves is, yeah, we're putting out testing equipment, we want to know what's coming over. And when you become familiar with the documents, you know that early on they were looking at 3 Mile and Chernobyl and modeling the NERAC and everything over these previous incidences. So there's plenty of evidence in the documents to show that it's this total bogus answer to the public. They know darn well it's going to travel across that Pacific jet stream current, and they know we're going to get hit. They talk about the testing from Chernobyl, what they found over here. So they know darn well. It's the third time this has happened. So my main, you know, contention with the alternative media is because they didn't jump on it. It's not just ruining Obama's election chances. I mean, that'd be nice and everything, and be nice to get a Green Party candidate in there that's against nuclear power. But we need to hold the alternative media accountable. They're not acting like an alternative media if we're not pushing these issues forward and highlighting them, showcasing them, and writing the articles like I do that ties in the whole big picture. So you see here, they know ahead of time everything that's going to happen, but we're told a different story. It's a two total different realities. Page 17, let's look at number 7. What happens when / if a plant melts down? Public answer. In short, nuclear power plants in the United States are designed to be safe. To prevent the release of radioactive material, there are multiple barriers between the radioactive material and the environment, including the fuel cladding. That's the zirconium cladding of the fuel rods. The heavy steel reactor vessel itself and the containment building, usually a heavily reinforced structure of concrete and steel several feet thick. Additional technical non-public information. The melted core may melt through the bottom of the vessel and flow onto the concrete containment floor. The core may melt through the containment liner and release radioactive material into the environment. This is one in my notes I marked down early on because it struck me as just such a radical difference between the two answers, where one's telling you not to worry, there's total containment protection and you know, no big deal, and the other one's giving you, you know, even closer to what's a realistic story. It's still not giving you the whole story about if it went down into the seawater, whatever. There's plenty of horror stories about the China syndrome, if we want to get into that. But it's more a step in the right direction of, hey, being honest, when it melts down and the containment is ruptured or it breaches containment, the reality is the plume is, it's all, plumes are always carried in there. In fact, NERAC models plumes all the time for all sort of industrial incidences. So they know the dynamics and the physics of plumes, I'll put it that way. Okay, now we want to advance to page 85. Bear with me as I forward in my computer. Page 85, and we're going to be looking at a number of, these are talking points again here pretty much, and we're looking at number 6. And this, I wanted to point this out because the question is, what other U.S. agencies are involved and what are they doing? Like I say, this is a grandiose, vast conspiracy. To pull this off and hide the radioactive plume and fallout from Americans, you have to have a massive net of snare of information, and that's just a plain fact. If you doubt that this information didn't get out, just ask your friends. I mean, on Facebook, most of my friends on Facebook are people that are in the realm of alternative media. They're posting stuff from these sites all the time. Well, I post my stuff, and I talk to them, and they still don't get it. They're still not getting it. Why? Because I am alone, the guy posting up the articles. They're not getting it from the alternative outlets. Right, they're not being pounded from these alternate. They say, hey, look, 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 pay attention, pay attention. So one guy alone can shout from the top of his roof for as long as he wants and grow hoarse, and no one will ever hear him. Hopefully this picks up a little bit of steam, and it begins to play into the alternative media, and we force them to act like what they're supposed to be. Right now it's a few people in the independent media that really understand this, and Chris Busby, I think, is the physicist who's really, I mean, when you look at the academia that are speaking out on this, it's few and far between. The only ones being honest, like Chris Busby, you can only see his videos when he's being interviewed in Europe or Thailand or some far, far away place, you know, and that's the level of control. The best we get is Arnie Gunderson. And my mom early on pointed out, said he's a shill. I said, how's Arnie a shill? He says, well, he's still for nuclear power. And he'll briefly mention the 40 documents, but he's not going to read you the thyroid doses to children in California. He's not going to read to you, no, we're not going to tell them this is not for public release. He's not going to give you that. He's not going to tell you they know all about Chernobyl and all this. He's not going to give you the lowdown dirty that's contained in these documents. So, again, it's damage mitigation. It's gatekeeping. They let a little bit out. You know, Prison Planet had to do something. That's a fact, because the articles I wrote plainly point an accusing finger right at it. It's been months and months and months and months. I've sent him all the information. I haunted his YouTube. I was a jerk about it. I really was, because I said to myself at the time, it's not made right. Something is not right. This story is huge. It is a monster. It's, you know, Watergate times 10. You know, Ollie North and Iran-Contra times 10. I mean, it's only the death toll of 40,000 and predicted to go over a million by, what, 2031, and I'm going to read these numbers to you in a minute. I'm getting fired up here because this is, it's unacceptable in this country anymore. People are going to need to, you've been on your couch nice and comfortable watching football, drinking beer, playing games, but now the time you're going to have to stop painting your belly for the football game and get your butt involved and become an investigative journalist and start speaking the truth. That's all I can say. Now let's go to number 10 here. Is there a danger of radiation making it to the United States? In response to nuclear emergencies, the NRC works... Wait a minute. Did I actually cover that last one, or did I get distracted there? The other agencies. Okay, let me go back. I got distracted. Exactly. Number six. These other agencies, I want to point out here, to be clear, that there's multiple agencies involved. The NRC is closely coordinating its efforts with the White House, DOE, DOD, USAID, and others. The U.S. government is providing whatever support requested by the Japanese government. In the beginning, it says the entire federal family is responding to the event. And that term, federal family, which is a worrisome term for me, because that's referring to them, okay, the government, the powers, the alphabet agents. They are the federal family. And if you want to think about it a little bit, doesn't it sound like we're not part of that family? It's a whole other family on and off to itself. We're the herd, we're the sheeple, and they are the federal family that's overseeing the sheeple. And that's it's mentioned throughout the documents, and that, boy, that's the feeling I sure get from it. It's like we don't even have a say or participation in this government at all. And they know it. They know it. Okay, is there a danger of radiation making it to the United States? In response to nuclear emergencies, the NRC works with other U.S. agencies to monitor radioactive releases and predict their path. The NRC continues to monitor information regarding wind patterns near the Japanese nuclear power plants. Nevertheless, given the thousands of miles between the two countries, Hawaii, Alaska, and the U.S. territories and the U.S. West Coast are not expected to experience any harmful levels of radioactivity. Well, pardon my French, but that's bullshit. And they knew this right from the beginning. When you clearly read through the Freedom of Information documents, they're public documents available on the NRC website. I have links to all of them in my articles. And I have a friend, Donna, who is now beginning to go through these, and she understands the, you know, the massive amount there is to go through, but also understands some of these critical statements, these damning statements made within that prove everything I've been saying all along. It's a huge cover-up. There's a 40,000 deaths. Not all could have been prevented. I give them that. But it's about government doing its role, its duty to protect U.S. citizens. And if FEMA and DHS are embedded and intimately involved, if they're reporting to the White House, but we don't hear anything about it, and we don't even hardly hear about it in the alternative media, folks, I'm telling you, we are in a bad spot right now, and it's not going to get better until we either replace elements of the alternative media or they start doing their job. And I suggest to you this, you know, the election is almost here. Undoubtedly, these same outlets that I've been questioning and I've cast doubt upon, they're going to want to start to talk more about the FOIA documents. Once Obama's reelected, no big deal, it can slip out. And if you look at 9/11, if enough time goes by, do you really expect people to be held accountable? Do you really expect people to go to jail? Or if years and years go by, can we pretty much say that no one's going to go to jail for 9/11? No one is. No one's going to go to jail for the federal building bombing. No one is. So the fact is we have to address these situations. The time is of the utmost importance is what I'm trying to say. We were failed by Prison Planet. We were failed by InfoWars and a number of other outlets as well. And these are the ones that claim to be the largest, the most important, blah, blah, blah. But you see what I'm saying? When this conspiracy is a lot provable, Holder has been issuing Fast and Furious is nothing. Again, I'm going to keep harping on that because this is Fast and Furious times 100. Times 100, that's my opinion, but... You know, I've been watching politics and reading books and paying attention, and I'm an intelligent, capable, coherent individual, so that is my analysis at the present time. Now we have one more to look at here. Let's look at number 12. This will be on page 85,